Hey guys, welcome to an auto review right here on ToyWorldOrder.com. I'm Devall. That.
Welcome to a Jurassic World review.
Spare no expense.
You have no idea, my friend. You have no idea.
So here's the deal. So we haven't been around since the sail barge. Things have been going on. A lot of stuff's been going on. Dave apparently has been
playing God.
Apparently.
With my friend Mr. DNA.
I like Mr. DNA. He's a good guy. Why you gotta bring him into this?
Just saying.
Dave has been hunting.
And Farmer Hoggett.
Dave has been hunting and anxiously awaiting the release of a certain Mattel Jurassic World product that technically isn't out in the States yet.
No. As we film this, we're probably about 2 to 3 weeks away from it. Technically.
And since it's a Target exclusive.
Since it's a Target exclusive.
And Target exclusive. Target stores are crap. You're never going to see it on the shelf. And if you do.
You mean like the exclusive Spinosaur from last year that did not actually get purchased by Target and put into stores.
That's right. This one, on the other hand, apparently is coming. But
maybe.
It's been available in Europe.
And other places.
And other places. Yes, yes. And Dave, again, spare no expense. Today, we're going to take a look at a figure Dave has wanted since the first Jurassic Park movie.
No.
That being the one and only Brachiosaurus. My God. 28 inches tall is this figure.
71 centimeters. According to this thing on the back.
71 centimeters. Yes. If you're into the metric.
Well, I mean, considering where I got it from.
Canada A?
No.
Europe A?
No.
Yugoslavia, eh?
No. So, as you see, like on the front, they've got the artwork of the Brachiosaur kind of from the scene. They even put the Paracelophysis. I'm mispronouncing that terribly. In the background.
What's
The ones with the pompadour. Elvis.
Elvis.
Yeah, in the other film. Then I don't know if that's going to read, but on the other side, they do it vertically. Yeah, okay. I'm not doing that because we don't want to get copyright struck. In our only video.
Just a couple seconds.
Yeah.
It's fine.
We could do like the actual like trailers for this movie. Bomb, bomb, bomb.
The box is huge though. It's a big box.
Now
you don't want to just see the box though. You want to see the actual figure.
Now for the record, there've been a lot of videos of unboxing the guy. He basically comes in three parts: the neck, the tail, and the body. So we're not really robbing you of a lot. By he doesn't even come into frame.
Oh my God! Tried to frame that up so he would. He don't even fit in frame.
No, it's a thing of beauty.
It is a thing of beauty. It's gorgeous though. Would you like me to put the tail?
Well, here's the thing. Like one issue I got to talk about.
Oh yes.
Is unfortunately.
Let's talk about the issue. So we'll talk about the figure. Let's talk about Dave's issue first.
Well, it's an unfortunate one. It's a production error. We're actually going to have to lift up her skirt, as Ian Malcolm says. If you can see, the whole back area is kind of open.
Yes.
There should be a plate or a cup that blocks it all off except for a little square, which the tail then plugs into.
Right.
Now, it kind of stays in there on its own, but there is supposed to be, I've watched enough videos, it's supposed to plug in, and it's like the other dinosaurs. If you have any of the other dinosaurs from the line, you probably know that it's like this, all this open area should be closed off. It should be just
so you
a
actually
little
got a
square.
Production error one.
Apparently, I did.
Really?
Yeah, because I have seen the ones that Mattel sends to reviewers are complete and fixed. But you know, the tail stays in there okay. I'm not gonna be playing with him. Really,
it'll be a display piece.
She'll go on the shelf and pretty much stay there.
Yeah. It's a marvelous looking figure. I mean, it's beautiful. Again, everything Mattel's done with the Jurassic World line has been spectacular.
It is, absolutely.
It is the best toy line on the market today.
I would say it's up there, probably. I would put this line with some of the top, like Star Wars and G.I. Joe.
Yeah.
I mean, they have really spared no expense.
Yeah. Better than the Hasbro crap we got before.
Pretty much the best stuff since the first film.
Best stuff since the Kenner stuff.
Which was the first film.
I know.
Now, in terms of articulation, we've been a little spoiled by Mattel.
Yeah.
The tail is supposed to wag, obviously, just sort of.
I mean, it kind of wags.
It kind of wags. It wobbles.
She's got a wobble tail.
Yeah, she does not have the ball joint articulated hips that a lot of the other dinos do, which is probably for the best, because she's got to support a lot of. Actually, it's very lightweight.
Yeah, it is. It's hollow plastic.
Yeah, it's hollow plastic, But it's still over. Believe me, some of the smaller ones I already have issues with the hips like bowing out.
Bowing out, yeah.
And then she's got the neck. The neck snaps in right here, which we didn't show you. And obviously the tail plugs into the tail.
Yeah.
And then her.
Her little mouth is articulated.
Little mouth articulated, so she can eat the pom
fronds. Yeah, she can eat the pom. And then she turns. She does turn from left to right there.
Yes.
Sadly, it's kind of awkward because they didn't build any joints. There's not a cut joint here, even though it shows.
Well, it's a separate piece.
It's a separate piece, but there should be
a cut joint. And the head's a separate piece, too.
Yeah. They should add a cut joint in the mid-neck and a cut joint at the head so you could maneuver it a little better.
I guess.
And pose her a little better. But
I mean, you know, again, they're not the most necessarily dynamic animals to have adventures with.
Right.
But, I mean, you know, she's gorgeous.
Oh, it's a great piece. I mean, it's perfect for any Jurassic World collector or Jurassic Park collector at this point, because this is a figure that Kenner never made, that no one's ever...
They did do Brachiosaurus, technically. A baby one came with Tim Murphy.
Yes.
I think for the third film, they did one that wasn't in scale. It was like this big.
Yeah.
But we've never had... I mean, there are like three sauropods I know that are this big. There's her. There's the Titanosaur from Definitely Dinosaurs. And then there's the Brontosaurus from Dino Riders.
Dino Riders.
Which are the only ones that are... And I think that one's out of scale.
The Jurassic World Park... the Jurassic World figures, they're G.I. Joe scale, right?
They are a little smaller. They are 3¾.
So here's the fridge. G.I. Joe's the fridge. There we go. We'll just stand him.
Yeah,
there we go.
So you get a sense.
some big dinosaur.
Yeah, I have this set up in my display, like, in front of, like, all... Like, she's in the background, and then there's, like, a bunch of the figures, and, like, the T-Rexes.
Yeah.
And she just... Dwarfs all of them. Yeah, it's amazing.
Again, it's a gorgeous figure. It's sad that she doesn't have more articulation. It's a giant hunk of plastic, so they kind of need some support.
Again, she's just a big lumbering beauty who just wants to eat her plants and you know, I mean the most
and not die thing, horribly in a lava explosion.
Yeah, that sucked. You know, sneeze on Tim Murphy or Alex Murphy.
God bless you.
Yeah. I think she's fine for what she is. She's a, you know. I think the sculpt is gorgeous.
Oh, God, yes.
Very detailed. It's
beautiful.
You know, like, you really notice it in the head, which is, you know, all the little wrinkles in the skin. It's an amazing piece.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, if you...
All right, Fridge, let's go back.
If you're like our friend Mikey Rosari and want rampaging brachiosaurs on the deck of the USS Flag killing people...
Sure. You can have that!
Specifically Bazooka. Yeah, she's maybe not... Perfectly designed for that.
Here, let's use.
Well, he specifically wanted him to kill Bazooka.
Use an old hawk here.
I mean, okay.
That was my fun for the day.
Well, you know, to be fair, his pants do kind of look like
like a plant.
Like a plant.
Well, they're camouflage.
Yeah,
blends in with the leaves.
That's what you get. He was hiding in the tree. That was a mistake.
That's gonna leave after that terrible joke.
Oh.
Well, there you go, guys. There's a look at the amazing Mattel Jurassic World Brachiosaurus. These things are going to be available in the States in the coming weeks. Allegedly.
I believe about $50. I think they're the same price as the Mosasaurus.
Which is a hell of a deal for a
figure
this big.
It is. I mean, good luck finding them. You know, I hope everybody who wants one gets one.
Target stores.
Yeah, my guess is they'll get like a case of two.
And then that's it for most Target stores.
I'm guessing. But
again, and then they'll advertise them all Christmas and not have them.
Probably. But if you can get one, I absolutely 100% recommend it. I think it's a great toy if you're a Jurassic World collector.
Yes.
If you're a dinosaur collector of any stripe, you how can you not have this gorgeous sauropod in your collection?
Beautiful figure.
If you're a Jurassic Park collector, I mean, just be there the day they get them in, buddy.
You can kind of get her to stand up on her back.
Yeah, I know. Like in the movie.
Yeah.
And boom.
Yeah. It's the first dinosaur you see.
It is. Well, yeah. You get a little glimpse of a raptor's eye.
Yeah. Gorgeous, though. Beautiful figure. I'm glad to thank you, Mr. Hammond, for bringing this amazing specimen into my home.
Next time, it'll be flawless. I'm doing like Sean Connery.
Like you are.
I know.
You're worse at it.
I'm bad at accents.
Next time.
Next time, money penner.
Sean Connery would have been great as Dr. Hammond. Spared no expense.
He would have.
Trebek, spared no expense. Spared no expense with your mother last night. Ah! Ha! Ha!
Okay. Trying to avoid that. Okay.
If you haven't seen Celebrity Jeopardy, you're missing out on old 90s stuff. It's great.
Yeah.
Anyway, gang, we'll be back next time with an all-new review, so make sure you tune in then. And until next time, David.
Keep playing with your toys.
Take care, guys. We'll see you later. I don't know why she's got a squeaky voice.
Yeah, no, they kind of use whale sounds.
Oh, yeah. Bye, guys. See you later.